Okay, we're all ready to install our heat stratification pipe inside our plastic tank. So we just slide it right in here like this. Wait a minute, am I missing something? Yes. We don't have a waterproof seal here, so we're gonna have to install a rubber boot in here first and then slide the heat stratification tube inside the rubber boot. Okay, so the rubber boots, they come from the Home Depot or other plumbing suppliers. Like, they look like this. Okay, it's about $6. But you're gonna need two rubber boots. Now the only thing is you don't really need something as wide, as long as that. So you can just cut it in half, like this. All right, so when you're working with them, you'll take the straps off, so the rubber boot will look like this. That's half a rubber boot, actually. So you want to install that in your hole. Remember, this is a drill with a circular saw, 2¾ inches. So fold it up like this, and then just pop it right in your hole this way. Now, it's still not a waterproof seal, and it won't be a waterproof seal until you press the 2-inch PVC into it. But we have to put a lubricant on this to slide it through. It's a very tight fit. Okay, let's do that next. Okay, our heat stratification pipe has been installed inside our plastic tank. Let's take one more look at it to make sure that we understand how this works. We know that the hot water from the collector is going to be entering here. Okay, so the first thing that will happen is the hot water, we want that to rise to the top of our tank. So you notice the heat stratification pipe has holes on the top here. So that'll direct the hot water towards the top of the tank. And then the natural tendency of the hot water to remain at the top because it's lighter than cold water will take effect. The holes are large to reduce the turbulence in the water so that the convection currents can work. Now, on the bottom side of this tube, we also have five holes, but those five holes are on the bottom, and they'll siphon the cold water from the bottom of the tank to the next tank. So basically we want this tank to be a hot tank, the next tank to be a slightly colder tank, and colder, so that the last tank will return the coldest possible water to the collector, and this maximizes the heat transfer process. Okay, that's the basic idea. All right, we're all ready to connect our plastic tanks. Be sure to mount your tanks on top of a nice level platform, preferably a cement platform. Make it nice and level so all your connections line up right. The other thing that you're going to want to do is, if it's for domestic hot water, you're going to want to install like a PEX or a polyethylene a tube inside to extract heat for your domestic hot water. If all you're using this for is home heating, you don't even need that. You're just going to collect the heat in these tanks. You put them in a storage vault, blow air across them, and you'll be collecting the heat. But you're going to need multiple tanks. That's the whole idea of this system. I mean, if you have one or two or three tanks, that's one thing. But if you have a dozen tanks, you're going to want a simple method of connecting them, and this is the method. So right through these rubber boots, if everything lines up right, we just put them together, and then we have your clamp. Tighten that up, and you're ready to go. One other thing, let's not forget the lids. Okay, it's just a styrofoam lid. We've done this before. That will keep the heat and steam inside your tank. You can also put a plywood cover on top of this. Okay, that's the basic idea for a do-it-yourself solar hot water heating system.
Grab your coat and get your hat. Leave your worry on the doorstep. Just direct your feet to the sunny side of the street. Can't you hear a pitter-patter? And that happy tune is your step. Life can be so sweet on the sunny side of the street. I used to walk in the shade with those blues on parade, but I'm not afraid. This rover crossed over. If I never have a cent, I'll be rich as Rockefeller. Gold dust at my feet on the sunny side of the street. This rover crossed over. If I never have a cent, I'll be rich as Rockefeller. Gold dust at my feet on the sunny side.